Welcome to this lecture on linear algebra. Today we are going to discuss about a very important and interesting concept regarding vector spaces, is the concept of a linear transformation. Linear transformation. So we are going to devise some mechanism so that two vector spaces can communicate with each other. So let us assume we have two vector spaces U and V, and we want to design some mechanism so that they can communicate. Communicate in a linear fashion. What we mean by this linear fashion is given in this definition. Let U and V be two vector spaces then a mapping or transformation T from U to V is said to be a linear transformation if two conditions are met. The first one is transformation of the sum is sum of the transformed vectors. And transformation of the scalar multiple of some vector is scalar multiple of the transformed vector. So this must hold for all U, V in the space U and for all alpha belonging to the underlying field. Equivalently, these two conditions can be written in a one condition like T of alpha U plus beta V is equals to alpha T of U plus beta T of V. So it is up to you whether you satisfy these two conditions or you can have some laborious calculations to put these two conditions into one. So first I will be giving you some examples. So T from RQ to R2 defined as T of XYZ is equals to XY0. So this is a linear transformation. T is linear. You can verify if you take two vectors from R3, x1, y1, z1, and then x2, y2, z2. If you take sum of these two, you will be getting x1 plus x2, y1 plus y2, z1 plus z2. So now we apply T on this sum of two vectors, T of x1 plus x2, y1 plus y2, z1 plus z2. Now look at the definition. After transformation, you retain the first two coordinates as it is and the third coordinate is zero. So we'll be having x1 plus x2, y1 plus y2 and zero. I have written in the column vector, you could write as a row vector. So x1 plus x2, y1 plus y2, 0. Now this is x1, y1, 0 plus x2, y2, 0. So I have split it, this triplet into two. So this by definition is T of U and this is T of v. This is the vector u. This is vector v. If you take t u, you will be having x1, y1, 0, and t of v will be x2, y2, 0. So I have used this. Now if you take alpha u, which will be alpha times x1, y1, z1, which is alpha x1, alpha y1, alpha z1, apply t on alpha u, will be t of alpha x1, alpha y1. What is the definition? You retain the first two coordinates and third is zero. So alpha is common, x1, y1, 0, and this by definition is t of u. So both the conditions are met. So t is a linear transformation. T is a linear transformation. So what this transformation is actually doing, so this is z, this is x, this is y. So this is taking vectors from 3D and we are projecting onto the xy plane. So here you will be getting the images. So input is from anywhere in this three-dimensional space, but the output is the xy plane. So this is also called projection on xy plane. Similarly, if you define t of xyz like 0yz or t of xyz is equals to x0z, so this is projection on yz plane. And this is projection on xz. So all the three transformations are linear transformations. So we define transformation from the space of matrices to the space of matrices by T of A, B, C, D is equals to, if we write like this, so this is transpose of A. In short, we could write T of A is equals to A transpose. Now we check whether this is a linear transformation or not. We know T of A plus B. By definition, this will be A plus B transpose. So A transpose plus B transpose, this is T of A plus T of B. Similarly, T of alpha A, by definition, you map alpha A onto alpha A transpose, alpha times A transpose, which is alpha T of A. So this is a linear transformation. Third example, now we map matrices space to the space of reals by T of A, B, C, D. So input is a matrix of order 2 cross 2, and we want to have some real number. So there are different ways to obtain a real number from a matrix. The first way is to take the sum of diagonal elements, which is called trace of A. You could also write trace of A. Let us verify whether this is linear or not. Transformation of u plus v. So in place of uv, I am writing av because we are dealing with the space of matrices. It's better to write a and v as the elements. By definition of the transformation, we compute trace of a plus b by the properties of trace. We have trace a plus trace b. So this is a T of A, and this is transformation of B. Similarly, T of alpha A is trace of alpha A. So alpha times trace of A, and this is by definition T of A. So T is a linear transformation. So we see taking trace of a matrix give rise to a linear transformation. Taking trace of a matrix gives a linear transformation. What about the determinant? Again, we define a transformation from the space of 2 cross 2 matrices to R by T of A, B, C, D, A, D minus B, C. So this is that of A, determinant of A. We know determinant of A plus B is the same as determinant of A plus determinant of B. So first property of linear transformation is satisfied, but we know determinant of some K times A is not equals to K times determinant of A. Rather, we have determinant of KA is K to the power N determinant of A, where N is the order of the matrix. In this case, the order is 2 cross 2, so K square determinant of A. So taking determinant is not a linear transformation. Taking determinant is not a linear transformation. Another example, the space P2 to P1. So we move from the space of all polynomials of degree 2 or less to the space of polynomials of degree 1 or less by T of AT square plus BT plus C, a second degree polynomial. If you want to obtain a first degree polynomial, so what we could do, we can differentiate. So derivative of AT square plus BT plus C. So you would be having 2AT plus B. So this is a linear transformation. As we know, derivative of P plus Q, if you take two polynomials of degree 2 or less, so this will be derivative of P plus derivative of Q. Otherwise, you could verify by this definition. I'm talking about general differentiation. So d by dt of alpha times P of T is alpha times d by dt of P. So taking this derivative give rise to a linear transformation. T from P2 to R. So from the space of polynomials of degree 2 or less, we want to have a real number. So real number hasil karne ke bahut sare procedures hain. Hum aise define karne ja rahe hain filhal ke jo bhi polynomial input ke taur par dein, us polynomial ko integrate kar dein over the interval 0 to 1. Agar hum isko expanded form mein likhein, second degree ka polynomial hai at square plus bt plus c. So 0 to 1, at square plus bt plus c. So again, this will be a linear transformation because in general, 0 to 1 f plus g is equals to 0 to 1 f. It doesn't matter whether you have 0 to 1 or any other interval for the space of polynomials. You could split this 0 to 1 g and alpha times 0 to 1 f dt is alpha times 0 to 1. So at the moment, this is acting as T, this definite integral. So T of F plus G is T of F plus T of G. So this integration gives rise to a linear transformation. There are other ways to define linear transformations between the spaces P2 to, let us say, we want to move towards R2. So I told you a linear transformation is actually a way to have some communication between these spaces. So अब input P2 का element है और हमें R2 में plane में जाना है. इसके भी बहुत सारे options हो सकते हैं. At the moment अगर हम ये ले लें कि एक second degree का general polynomial है जो कि input के तौर पर आ रहा है. So इसको मैं अगर P of T लिख दूँ, मुझे R2 चाहिए, मैं मुझे एक ordered pair बनाना है. तो मैं इस polynomial को zero पे compute कर लूँ, इस polynomial को one पे compute कर लूँ. तो ऑफ कोर्स जब आप पॉलीनोमियल में टी की जगह जीरो रिप्लेस करेंगे, अवैल्यूएशन करेंगे एट टी इक्वल्स टू जीरो, तो एक रियल नंबर आएगा और टी इक्वल्स टू वन पे भी एक रियल नंबर ऑफ कोर्स मिलेगा आपको. तो आप आर टू में मूव कर जाएंगे. व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज दैट विद दिस डेफिनेशन, अगर मैं इस पे टी अप्लाई करना चाहूँ टू टी स्क्वायर प्लस थ्री टी प्लस फाइव पे, सो बाई डेफिनेशन मुझे चाहिए पी ऑफ जीरो एंड पी ऑफ वन. So P of 0 will be 5, क्योंकि ये दोनों टर्म 0 हो जाएंगी. P of 1 will be 2 plus 3, 5 plus 5, 10. So this is a transformation that takes any second degree or less polynomial and moves it to the plane R2. So you see, with the linear transformation, totally different vector spaces can communicate. You can establish a connection between two different spaces. So this is a linear transformation. You can verify T is a linear transformation. So another example, this was example 7. Example 8, T from M2 cross 2. You could take Mn cross n. मैंने जितने भी examples 2 cross 2 के हिसाब से दिए, trace लेना, determinant लेना, आप general matrix के ले सकते हैं. So R2 to R2, M2 cross 2 to, let us say, R4 by T of A, B, C, D. So this is a 2 cross 2 matrix as input. मुझे output चाहिए 4 dimensional space में. So सबसे simple ये है कि यही जो matrix के अंदर entries हैं, इनको एक column vector में लिख दीजिए. So this T is a linear. You could verify this is a linear transformation. So you see कि matrices R4 से communicate कर रहे हैं. Polynomials की space R2 से communication कर रही है. इसी तरह पॉलीनोमियल्स की स्पेस आर के साथ कम्युनिकेट कर रही है. सो यू कैन डिफाइन ए ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन बिटवीन टू स्पेसेस, टोटली डिफरेंट स्पेसेस, एंड देन यू कैन चेक वेदर दिस इज लीनियर आर नॉट. सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ नॉन लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, टी फ्रॉम आर थ्री टू आर थ्री डिफाइंड एज T of x, y, z. So if I map x to x plus 1 and y on y, or let us say 2y and z on z, this is not a linear transformation because of this one. You can verify when you take sum of two vectors, you will be getting here as 2. And but when you apply separately, so the sum would be different. So you can check u as x1, y1, z1, and t of u by definition is x1 plus 1, 2y1, z1. Similarly, if you take v from R3, x2, y2, z2, t of v will be x2 plus 1, 2y2, and Z2. When you take sum of these two, x1 plus y1, x2 plus y2, z1 plus z2. Transformation after the sum, by definition, you have to add 1 in the first entry, twice of the second entry, and third as it is. So this is t of u plus v. You could say this is 1, left hand side, and t u plus t v from these two, you will get x1 plus x2 plus 1 plus 1, that is 2. So you don't need to check the other entries. This is different from this. So t is not linear. T is not linear.